So we've seen the mouse, thanks to Ms. Lupina. Now let's meet some drivers. The drivers to the Broadmoor Highway that constructed in Albany. And let's meet this elegant salon is for you, dear gentlemen. Let's meet Mr. Alfred Gega, Head of Network and Service Operator at Vodafone. Mr. Gega, I set this chair for you. This is best. Let's meet Mr. Ilir Duga, Radio Transmission Engineering Department Manager from Amatet. Mr. Duga, welcome. Mr. Murat Chakmak, CTO of Alt Telecom. Welcome, Mr. Chakmak. Mr. Dragos Mitzea Rebeja, said well. Thank you very much, you're welcome. Mr. Athanasios Karanasis, Area Manager for Adran. Five rows and copies are coming. Welcome. Mr. Igor Kupaleski, Business Development Director, Intelligent Network Solutions. Welcome. And last but not least, Mr. Dimitris Palakotronis, CEO of Fastmetrics. Welcome. Please, next one. Arrange yourselves. Way too many. So, let's have a little heat up. Mr. Gega, since we are, if you can see, you have three providers, okay? Two constructors, and two guys here left. His role is a mystic role. It's to monitoring the networks about quality and propose out-of-the-box solutions. You can see it. Mr. Gega, since broadband is a key feature of digital growth, what are the targets you aim on in order to expand broadband dissemination? And by the way, please can tell us what is your feedback about the 3G acceptance in the market? Yes. Or you can you can raise your voice. Give us more volume, please. Can you help us here?
As I said, Vodafone was the first operator launching 3G in Albania, and we believe it was well accepted from all the customer base. Actually, we're covering 80% of the network with 3G coverage, as it was, let's say, foreseen by the license. And still, our plans are to expand our HSPA class 43.2 coverage this year and the coming year as well. We believe that the plans for all mobile operators in Albania now are to look forward to deploying LTE in Albania, because we believe that digital broadband, especially in the rural areas, will be a complementary service. Let's say complementing the fixed broadband.
Mr. Luca, what about the 3G in Albania? Did you manage to find customers?
Yes. Well, thank you, first of all, for the invitation and having this opportunity to express some thoughts about it. AMC, since the US is offering product services in the Albanian market via UNTS network, or for which the license has been taken, let's say, end of 2011. And it really has been a point of transformation and a change for our network. Since 15 years, we are running GSM 2G network. And okay, at this moment, the last 2 years presented really, let's say, a transformation in all aspects of our network infrastructure. Okay, we're developing, in order to be ready for UMTS, we're developing transport network, let's say, to support all the traffic demand, let's say, generated by 3G, an Ethernet-based transport network, dimensioned enough capacities to support the trend, the increased trend. We have used our footprint of GSM network, 2G network, in order to facilitate and run very fast the deployment of 3G network. And in 18 months, we covered last obligations of covering 85% of territory. And today we cover more than 85% of territory and more than 95% of the population. We have been as well taking some decisions at the very beginning where our focus has been in offering, in creating some competitive advantages, offering the highest speed practically, let's say, that was 42 megabit per second in sites in big cities. And currently we have more than 70% of our network offering HSP cast 42 megabit per second and 21 megabit per second configured in our network. As well, we dare since the very beginning to give to encourage usage of the 3G network, having it as the first choice of every customer, meaning that our first choice of mobile calls is 3G layer rather than 2G layer. It was a little bit, let's say, a brave decision, but it paid off, I believe, because we saw the increased usage of data in our network, and even from a quality perspective, we saw that we had a very good indicators measured by reliable, let's say, companies in this year.
Do you agree with Mr. Gieka that 3G coverage in rural areas can substitute the fixed coverage?
Indeed, for Albania country, I believe, let's say, for its stage of development, for its morphology of the terrain, it will be, let's say, in these rural areas, the only solution. And we should work, let's say, to offer enough speeds there, enough data rates via wireless. Because it would be very difficult at, in fixed ways to reach these, let's say, rural areas and isolated villages.
Thank you. Mr. Chakman, where does our telecom to expand its network? And what is, after you merge with Eagle, you have also a picture about the 3G coverage.
As Eagle Mobile, we are the third operator in that 3G license. So, as our competitors, we are using the same technology, which is for plus and for 42 megabits. And actually, service is very welcomed by the society. Now, in less than 1 year, we covered 8% of the population for 3G, and our data usage is increased more than 15 times in this duration. Our plan is in the next few months to reach the capacity coverage of 2G by using refarming technologies of low frequencies like 900 and the real tracking parameters technology. And our users in all territory will access to our 2G network. We also believe the 4G LTE that it will be the future of the broadband. And almost 1 year ago, we made our first 4G trial kit, and we reached 140 megahertz peaks already 1 year ago. Of course, now we are fixed and mobile operator. We are running parallel lines, so we also invest on fixed broadband. And again, almost 1 year ago, we have tested first time GPON technology. Here and we reached 1 gigabit in 14 kilometers distance. So we are following all technologies, the latest ones, and we will try to bring them as soon as possible to the Albanian.
These are good numbers. You expect also numbers of customers. And by the way, there is a trend for all operators to offer a full range of services like fixed, mobile, TV. You already did it with Eagle. What is the feedback you have received from the market? Does the customer prefer to have a buy pack?
We call it this commerce services, and it is really appreciated by our customers. When we start bundle our services with fixed and mobile, we saw that it was something created by the market. So it's going well. So we continue with our commerce services, and as a new one will include IPTV very soon. It is also trials are almost completed. In the next months, new year, we will launch also our IPTV services. So also this year we launched public Wi-Fi services in Albania, especially in China. So we are trying to cover all part of broadband needs, telecommunication needs. This is our target, and we are working on this.
Thank you very much. Mr. Rebeja, according to your experience, what are the factors that stimulate but also hold back infrastructure dissemination? Actually, the demands come from customers, from devices, from applications. Please.
Thank you very much, Margelis, and thank you for inviting me and Ericsson to participate to this event. Very, very honored to be here with my colleagues from the Albanian ICT domain. And thank you for the questions. I think many people have discussed thoroughly the broadband, fixed mobile broadband, and the plans of EU and the plans of the government of Albania in this area. And we believe that government definitely has a role, key role in shaping the broadband market in Albania, but not only in Albania. So I refer here to the legislation and the regulation. To be a bit more specific, I think everybody was mentioning the need of having more frequency spectrum allocated telecommunication services. You will notice that I will refer more to the mobile part rather than the fixed part.
Yeah.
But I will expect my colleagues to complement this. So the need of allocating more frequency spectrum it's there. Minister Haito has mentioned about the upcoming LD. So we all hope that the spectrum will be available in existing frequency band, in new frequency band. It was also mentioned about the neutrality and the technology agnostic spectrum, so-called refarming. Also, Mr. Chakmak mentioned about this. So we know very well that in order to be able to develop the infrastructure, especially the mobile infrastructure and mobile services in the rural area, we need lower frequency band. And I refer here to 900 MHz, 800 MHz band. So these are factors that, in our opinion, will contribute to the development of the mobile broadband. Definitely, we all expect that government to continue to play a key role. Let's not forget that in many countries, and including Albania, the government is one of the major investors in the ITC industry. Definitely, there are also factors which may, let's say, hold back the development of broadband and the ITC sector, and this is related to tariffs, for instance. We spoke about the upcoming, let's say, tender auction or process for awarding new spectrum. This has to be very well calibrated with the operator's budget and interest and needs. Also, continuity. We all expect to have a continuity in the implementation of the government strategies.
This is a problem for all countries.
Exactly. So these can be some factors that can hold back the development of the ICT sector in Albania.
So So you think that the government has a key role and he can contribute to the broad recovery?
Especially in countries like Albania, definitely the government has an orchestrated role. Of course, it's not the only player in this ecosystem, are the mobile operators, are the vendors. As mentioned before, the public-private partnership is also very important here.
When you say countries like Albania, you mean that the rural areas should be covered by mobile networks? Difficult country.
Definitely. Okay, looking to the geography of the country, looking to the economical situation of the country, looking also to the intention of Albania to join EU, all these are factors that definitely influence, let's say, the penetration of the mobile broadband in the rural area. But definitely the direction is there. I mean, we operators, government, technology provider, to contribute, all of us, to have a broadband affordable for everybody.
Thank you. Mr. Garanas, what are your experience? What are the factors that stimulate the broadband expansion? And take the pass from Mr. Dragos. You are in fiber optics construction. Okay? Even the mobile networks need backbone, need connection.
First of all, I would like also to thank you for inviting Adrian to participate in this conference. I will take up the job to discuss more of the fixed network, given the part of my colleague from Ericsson. So Adrian is a company focusing on fixed broadband access equipment and solutions. If we need to answer with one phrase what is stimulating the traffic, I would say it's the whole ecosystem, is each one of us, since we demand to be connected every day, anytime, any place, to use the social networks, to Google everything on the spot as we discuss it and we want to find details. And then, of course, new services like e-services, cloud services, all these multiply the need for increasing the speed in networks and building up more modern networks. And in addition to that, of course, we also have to consider how much faster new technologies and new applications are adopted by new generations. In comparison to older times. So all this creates the needs to build faster networks. Now our target is, first of all, is to cover this increase, this increased need, and secondly, to serve all, meaning that we need to break down any existing wall that separates served from unserved areas. And I think this can be managed by only if we use innovative technologies that can bring the service practically everywhere.
And this innovative technology, has copper has a role?
Yes, of course. We have invested a lot in technologies that bring new services over the existing copper networks. I think we are pioneering this area by delivering solutions that do not require the fiber layout in order to bring a new service.
You're speaking about the last mile or more wide areas of network?
Last mile can also be a DSLAM located in a building. So, if you can go to a house with a DSLAM that does not require fiber but can work with copper in the backhaul area, then you got it.
And despite the technology, as a constructor, as an implementer constructor, what will be your motive to start involved in the fiber optics construction? What are the guarantees that you're looking for?
Actually, we are not seeking guarantees. But since we know from experience that implementing such high complexity projects needs full commitment from all involved parties, I would say that we need to ensure that such plans are based on sustainable business plans that allow us to invest smartly, and that means allow us to invest gradually and to implement a network gradually. I mean, not spend everything from day zero, which is not sustainable, is not viable. So we have to grow the...
Follow the demand.
Yeah, to follow the demand. In parallel, as I said, coming back to the previous point, in parallel to serve all the other areas that are not yet covered by technologies that can work with no fiber, and in parallel to move the fiber always closer to the end user.
Thank you. Mr. Kopalewski, we spoke about dissemination of networks, we spoke about capacity, didn't speak about quality. Has a quality role to the customer or to the operators?
Yeah, thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you for the question. I will speak a little bit about how to board a ticket to digital highway and pay attention on this quality of service and quality of experience parameters. I totally agree with all the speakers and the operators, and they are absolutely right. And there is one, according to the European Union and BERC, there is a direct approach that is very important for the countries, not European, and for the countries that are going to be a part of the European Union, which says that it's very important transparency. It means that transparency is not bad, it's a good thing. How to manage the transparency? It's a transparency of general parameters of the offer, for example, availability, data speed, accessibility, but also there is a transparency of the restrictions. It is good to communicate with the operator, with the end customer, what are the restrictions that you are giving to the customer. This is not a bad thing. This is also stimulated with the European Union just to be communicated with the end customer. Some kind of restriction is a fair usage policy. It's not bad, it's a good thing. And the third part that is that they're paying a lot of attention, it's traffic management. The operators are doing traffic management, and it must do traffic management for the end customers, but it should be communicated with the customer. It should be transparently communicated. The second thing that I want to mention also here for quality of service parameters is it's education. It's not education only for the Western Balkans, not for the Albania and other countries here. It is very important education. It was pointed in the UK on the survey of Ofcom. It was about 35% of the population, of the people, are not educated what they can get from their offer. So education is very simple. And the most important education for the most important part of the education is done by the operators. They're educating the customers, their customers. It's also a simple way how you can educate. It's not only a word about what kind of service I'm offering and what is the speed. You're seeing what is going to get as a fare because they know what they want. And this education is a very important part, and the European Union is paying a lot of attention for the education. Also, there is one thing that I want to mention, it's a common frame of reference. It means terminology. Very important thing is terminology, just to have a common terminology, not to make confused your end customer with the technical terms that you are using in your offers. It means some simple words, for example, not data stream, something like music, video, and some stuff like that, which will be more clear to the end customer. In many cases, they don't want, for example, 40 megabits per second. They need only 1 megabit per second, but to be stable. So these are the things that must be somehow mentioned, transparent, communicated with operators and the end customers. And also there is a systems and there is applications and platforms that can measure this. So the end customer can choose the right offer on the market. They're not going to be confused anymore if they have a system for measuring the quality of the service and the experience that they're going to get during the contract.
Thank you very much. Mr. Filipatrovich, I have a question. That's my job. Last year, I remember 5 years ago maybe, we could predict data traffic, voice traffic. They have peak times, traffic areas, all the networks could predict the voice traffic. But right now, with data, the usage maybe is unpredictable. Everybody needs everything, every time. Has Fastmetric has any tool, any suggestion to overpass the situation?
First of all, thank you for the invitation in the conference. Fastmetrics is dealing with two different areas. One, communication radio technology, broadband radio technology. And the first area is services of radio technology, benchmark networks, and quantifying the quality, data quality and voice quality of a network or between the networks. And the second area in the radio technology team is products that enhance the radio interface. Now, I heard the previous speakers, I fully agree with their positions. We need to make clear, however, that when we communicate to our customers our good networks, we need to divide this communication into three layers. The first layer is that, yes, we do have coverage everywhere. The second layer, going deeper, is that, we also have capacity as well. So everybody can make the call, data call or voice call. And the third one is that we do have coverage, we do have capacity, but also we have quality. So the data speeds, the network speed, and finally, we provide the user experience we promised. Now, these three different layers have a huge impact, let's say, on investments that the network has to perform. We handle differently every layer. So if we want release 99 3G coverage, it's okay, we can say that we offer broadband access. But it's different to say that we offer 8 HSPA or 8 HSPA plus. And of course different than saying that we have LTE network or 4G. So I fully agree that we do make people don't understand what exactly we want to say. We are in the same industry. Now, we need to bear in mind one extra thing, as you said, Vangelis. Voice is over. We do not design networks today having voice in mind. Voice was a crystal clear thing. We knew the busy hour. We knew where the busy hour was taking place, so we knew the area. So we added the needed capacity in order to satisfy the busy hour, our customers on the busy hour. I'm sure that none network in the world designs for 3 o'clock in the morning. All networks designed for, let's say, 11 o'clock in the morning. But this was old. This was back in the past. We knew the busy hour was a slot, 1 hour and 24 hour day, that we knew it, where it was, and how big the demand will be every day. Now with data, we have a different thing to handle. We have not a single busy hour and not a single spot, geography spot. So now we go from layer 1 coverage, we go to capacity and say, can we give capacity, can we give broadband access to our customers everywhere, also covering the busy hour? After we manage to do this, which means cost for the network, then we go to quality. Then we have to talk about high speed broadband access. That's my position.
Thank you very much. Please, Mr. Abidjan.
Just to make it more interactive, not to have the feeling that everything gets arranged between us. I would like to challenge a little bit what, and to complement actually what Mr. Popalescu and Mr. Kolokotronis mentioned before about network quality. I would like to start making a small parallel regarding how we need to adapt to the changes. And I believe when it comes to network quality, all of us, network operators and technology providers, will need to adapt. You remember the nice introduction of Mr. Notis with the two mobile phones,
yep.
And the introduction of mobile communication 40 years ago. If you think better, none of the mobile handset manufacturers that were started at that time are present now. Mm-hmm. So some of them disappeared, some of them withdrew from the handset market. So definitely all of us, we need to change. And when it comes to network performance, Ericsson has conducted through a special division called Consumer Lab some studies and asking smartphone users, which we all know that these are actually the engines of the broadband, especially the mobile broadband, what is the most important for them, what they request from the mobile operators. And surprising or not, on the first place, 30% of the people saying that it's network quality. Second place is actually the price, and third place it was the coverage. So also the front runners of mobile market, of the mobile operators, the ones that are having the biggest growth in revenues are the ones which are managing the best the traffic, the mobile traffic, and they have the best network. So if yesterday, when we spoke about quality, it was about handling more data. Nowadays, it seems that it's about handling more needs, because the customers have more needs. Just think that somebody can need to stream an HD video. Somebody would like to have a secure transaction like e-commerce or payment. Somebody needs indoor coverage because it's a user that stays indoor and needs to have the best service. Somebody is a fan of gaming and needs low jitter and low latency service. So we believe in Ericsson that it's not anymore talking about coverage or network coverage, it's now more about application coverage. So basically it is about where my application or my applications will work acceptable. Doesn't matter if the application is video or the email or web browsing or whatever. So this seems to be a kind of change in the concept related to quality. Of course, if we look to KPIs, some time ago we were measuring quality by network availability, by call drop rate, by speed quality. Now everybody and my colleagues here, they were discussing about latency, about speed, about jitter. So everything is changing. But what we believe is centric now to the industry, it's actually the application. So what the consumer is consuming, not necessarily how the network looks like. It's very good 42.2 megabit per second, but I believe that the consumer, they don't know exactly this, but if their application or applications are working fine, it will be happy, and this will increase the loyalty.
What are consumers are consuming? Consuming data. The data, what are originated from? Mr. Gega, can you give us a vision about Vodafone? Vodafone wants to put content to their mobile, to their customers' mobile content, like games, like applications, their own content. And if yes, where the content will be?
Very good question. Actually, we are working to provide a full package. We started this year with Vodafone Red, and as part of this package we had this Cloud Contact and Protect, which are very good applications in my opinion, to offer to the subscribers secure content, to offer them the possibility to keep in a safe place all the contacts and all the content like video, like photo, like music, And whenever they change the phone or the tablet, they could, let's say, transfer easily this content to the new device. But this is something that is already in place in Albania as part of this Vodafone package. However, we are still working and planning to launch some new services in the coming year. Part of it will be also M-Pesa, which is somehow offered. Some similar services are offered through M-Pay, but we plan to deploy it in an innovative way using our Vodafone network and also Vodafone shop chains. On top of that, there are a lot of other applications we plan to launch it next year, and we believe it will be well accepted by the customers, because it's exactly what you said, that subscribers are looking mostly not to the HSP Plus or to other, let's say, fancy technology, let's say, terminology. However, they look towards the new application, and it's very important for them the quality of service we offer. So this is more or less what we're trying to do.
And to expand this content and applications, are you going to improve synergies with other ICT vendors?
This is a very good question for the CEO, actually. But we do not.
Do you have any instructions from the CEO to expand?
We do not exclude any possibility of cooperating in the future with other ICT vendors.
Thank you. Technically speaking, Mr. Luca, what are the difficulties that you face about broader expansion physically?
Okay, without difficulties, in fact, let's say for the digital infrastructure that we have created, especially for the UMTS network, that infrastructure, let's say, creates all the possibilities to accommodate all the traffic and let's say it has not, from this perspective, has not a big difficulty to build and to develop a 3G network, because we are using the existing footprint of 2G, of the previous 2G network. And by a transformation that we are doing, we are, let's say, creating all this room for even short-term and mid-term evolution of data traffic. We don't see the difficulties from this perspective in what we are capable to do, but mainly the difficulties may be related with, let's say, existing infrastructure of the country in terms of, because it is sometimes in periods of the year we see as a fight in order to keep available our sites in terms of access roads, which during winter time are blocked, or public infrastructure, which still lacks some deficiencies in terms of providing 24 hours electricity, and in periods of time, let's say we run our sites with generators, and this has a cost as well, let's say. The existing infrastructure of the network of Albania, let's say, sometimes create difficulties for us, and as well the, let's say, underground infrastructure in terms of fiber optics also is seen as an let's say supportive for future development of the ICT operators in terms of unlimited transfer capacities. Okay, we saw in the Atlas that there is band, let's say, of roads covered by Albanian, let's say, infrastructure, roads covered by, let's say, underground infrastructure, but maybe the quality of them, or when you need to take that, you see that there are a lot of issues, or lack of capacities, or cuts because of the development of the areas. And it needs a better coordination with the local governments, municipalities, or metropolitan areas, especially in order to keep, let's say, a smooth running of the business from this perspective, infrastructure.
Thank you very much. Mr. Schachmar, you spoke about mobile broadband, content, so I'll try to repeat the same question that with Mr. Geger. Does your business and plans and scenarios include the synergies with other ICT vendors?
Okay, so before answering this question, I want to give some answers for some previous
questions. Of course.
You have a mic. Yeah, our friends mentioned about the quality KPIs of the networks. I think none of the operators here are lying, and we are day by day keeping our eyes on our network and measuring all the quality parameters, parameters to give better service to our customers. From application point of view, we believe that we cannot compete with the big application providers like App Store or Google Play. There are millions of applications that they are offering. So our goal as operators to become a highway to this application of stores. Our customers should easily access and use these applications. Another discussion was about the terminology of the technologies. Yes, we are all using same technologies. It doesn't matter the names, but who is providing the best, fastest, and with the stable quality? This make a difference. To create a difference, we connected almost all our 3G sites with the fiber optics, so to provide better transport capacity. So we are aware of this need, and we are trying to fulfill of this need. And another thing for application point of view, we made some partnership with big providers like Google. For more than 2 years, we are hosting YouTube services here in Albania. So our customers are not accessing through USA to watch YouTube videos. They are watching them locally. So by this, systems quality and speeds are improved so much. So yes, we are cooperating with ICTs and global wise, we are cooperating with them. And try to be, bring the all services in Albania.
And also, it's a European, it is a European trend to go towards a national common broadband provider for all Europe or nationally, first of all. And the competition will be focused on service. Are you in favor of this idea?
Partially, yes, there's competition on mobile broadband, but we cannot ignore fixed broadband as well, because we believe that some services cannot be covered yet by mobile, especially in the media part. The demand is increasing every day. Now we are discussing HD video services, but now it's coming ultra HD video services, which cannot be handled with mobile broadband at the moment. So fixed broadband will stay for some services which requires very, very high bandwidth. We are planning, as I said, for Japan services, so we can say fiber to home projects, and we will, our next projects, the fixed part will not be anymore copper cable, so it will be fiber to home, and we will try to provide up to 1 gigabit capacity for each home for these high demand services. So we believe that mobile broadband and fixed broadband have some have different features. We are investing both of them. We are supporting 4G on the mobile part, but still we are continuing to invest on the fixed broadband.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Mr. Beja, what about a common provider?
Yeah, I will have
to. Are you in favor? You can handle this task?
Let me first give some compliment a little bit what Mr. Chakmak said about fixed broadband versus mobile broadband, because I think it's interesting and I think it complements well, let's say, the local reality here in Albania, which sometimes might be different than a global level. Also to complement it with some worldwide facts and figures regarding this. Yes, we truly believe that fixed and mobile broadband will coexist. Mm-hmm. And to give some numbers, today actually only 5% of the data traffic worldwide is mobile. The rest is fixed. So the big traffic it's still fixed, and of course it's fixed broadband. Indeed, the growth of the mobile data traffic versus fixed data traffic is different, and it's in the favor of the mobile traffic. So a fixed broadband traffic, it's growing with something like 25% CAGR, while mobile traffic goes up to 40-45%. So somewhere in the time, the two will be equalized, and maybe mobile will be above the fixed. But for the moment, fixed traffic it's still dominant. However, the more infrastructure, wireless infrastructure, I'm saying, is built out, it's more sites, new faster technology is coming, rural area is covered, then this gap between the mobile traffic and fixed traffic will be smaller. So we can see also that many of the players, big players also, are looking for fixed mobile convergence. If you look to the biggest group operators, they both have fixed and mobile services. So here I believe Altelecom and Eagle Mobile have a very good position, having both, and I'm sure that also the other players locally or at regional level, they have plans, and they're actually active in both fixed and mobile. Now, coming to a question, that's something difficult to comment from a vendor perspective. Definitely it should have an economical basis. Definitely this, let's say, national broadband network should serve the economical needs of all the players, not only their needs, but also the other operators' needs, the government needs. So from our point of view as a technology provider, as a network infrastructure provider, we are very happy to work with any customer and any operator. That's not the problem. But I can't have a bold opinion about the opportunity of having this network here. If I'm not wrong, I'm not Albanian, but I'm living in Albania, this is happening. So let's see how this is developing.
Thank you very much. Mr. Karanas, the same question, please.
Okay,
how about a common network provider?
Okay, but first, can you also allow me to comment on the
base
of the fixed mobile broadband. So I have to say that we all agree that the mobile broadband has made huge steps and has increased the speed that can offer tremendously. However, there are services, as Mr. Chakmak said, that cannot be delivered via mobile broadband. And to use the words of a telecom analyst when he was asked to comment on the freedom that mobile broadband brings to us, he said it's the same kind of freedom that a prisoner feels when he is one day out of prison. He wanders a little bit around, but at the end of the day, he's going back to
Germany.
So in that sense,
yeah, there are physical limitations, of course.
Yeah, we all feel very glad and very happy to have the mobile service, broadband services, wherever we are. But when things get serious, I think we all think we need to go home to our fixed lines. So I think. I also heard that comment before. This should not be treated as a competition, but as a complement.
Of course.
So, yes. Also in rural areas, for example, that one may consider that mobile broadband brings a lot of advantages. I would say they are short-term advantages because they allow you to implement the network faster and cheaper. I would say that in order to have these short-term advantages, one would use innovative solutions to implement fixed broadband services, as I said before, using copper, etc. And this way you will avoid to create a digital divide. Because if you say that in the villages I will served only with mobile broadband, then inevitably these areas will always be a step behind the rest of the country with the fixed broadband services. So coming to the point of the national wholesale infrastructure provider, as you call it.
It could be made by shareholders.
Yeah. I mean, this is a practice that has been followed in many countries worldwide. I understand that, we as Atran, we do not see our interest in a very close way to say that it is for our interest to sell more to each operator, but I think the practice shows that in order to build modern networks, there has to be a cooperation, a common infrastructure, at least in the passive equipment, in the passive network, because it doesn't make sense, for sure, that each operator will dig the country to lay their own fiber. It would be much more beneficial to commonly build this infrastructure and then to intensify the efforts on delivering applications.
Thank you. Mr. Popov-Paleski, according to your experience, we spoke about the theory of equality. What's the real equality that networks offer?
Thank you very much. Now, I totally agree with all previous speakers that the network provider should become a content provider and to deliver content with high quality services. I will just mention, we speak about technology all the time, but we can mention something about prices, the comparison with the prices. In our country, I can share some experience that in Q2 2012, compared to Q2 2013, it was a growth of 89% of the fixed broadband of the fixed operator, Deutsche Telekom. That was because of the intensive rollout of fiber network in the country. At the same moment, it was about the DSL and the copper, the growth was same, even it was saturated. Also, the prices for this were keeping the same. It means that they are offering something from 25 to 150 euros per month, and still the services and still the prices are the same. So now the war in our country was changed from price war into performance war. Into performance competition, but it was only on the fixed broadband. For the mobile broadband, they started with a zero, and now we know that below zero they are giving every offer for the voice and SMS. But still, the data for the prices last year, data are the same. Average revenue per user is the same for the data last year and this year, and the growth is more than 50% of the users that are using mobile broadband in our country. So these aspects are important for the operators because they are investing a lot of money for the infrastructure, and still when they are delivering content, applications, and in their networks, that they have faster return of their investment. So I will finish with that it is true that what was the copper last 20-30 years, now the fiber will be the next 30 years in the... So the major players are aware of that and they are following this. And you have a big tube, and you need just to fill it with applications, with the content, and that way the end customers will be more satisfied. This is the experience that is in other countries, this will come here in Albania as well. So in other countries, I can mention that for measuring of quality of service and quality of experience, according to your question, they have systems that they are measuring. But they are not punishing the operators. They are just giving transparency to the customer just to choose the right offer. This is the situation in Latvia, the situation in Italy, in Greek, in Western countries. Even more in Sweden, there is one site, Bredbandsskåne.com, which is not a regulatory body. It is a non-government, I think, some institutions that are delivering transparent results of the measurements for mobile and fixed broadband to the end customer. And according to the geographic area, they can choose what kind of vendor they're going to they can choose and what they get from the offer.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And Mr. Kolopatronis, and it would be the final question because we're running out of time. You are a solution vendor, so I suppose you believe in synergies. Yes or no?
Yes and no. That's a tricky question.
What did I give you?
It doesn't have a single answer. That depends on many things. Maybe internally, on each operator and the operator strategy. I would like to say that as far as I'm concerned, can speak only about mobile broadband, but we have nothing to do with fixed. Mobile traffic, 80% of mobile traffic is shared from 20% of the infrastructure. As a rule of thumb, so bear in mind that 80% of the revenue is generated from 20% of the radio site, as a rule of thumb. Meaning that offering quality wireless broadband, we need to focus on this 20% of our infrastructure. The rest 80%, it's a huge investment, already took place because this 80% serves for coverage. Talking about capacity, we're talking about the 20% of our infrastructure. So we need to focus on one very important thing, which is the quality of our infrastructure in this 20% of the of our radio sites, of our base stations. Generally speaking, the challenge today and facing the European challenge of 2020 is for mobile broadband, the well-named cost per bit. So how much I need to pay, what's the invested dollar, the invested euro for every data bit, wireless data bit I offer to my customers. And there we will see that because wireless is not a fiber optic, it's not a fixed environment, it's random, it's the air interface. We need to focus on very much on quality in order to reduce this cost per data bit. We have, and I will speak for our company now, we're making infrastructure for the base stations, which are focusing on how to control the antenna. And controlling the antenna, the revenue source of a mobile operator, is very important because the antennas are directional and we know how sensitive wireless is on interference and how sensitive is mobile data on power supply. So, I would like to say that there are many ways that, in closing, without wanting to waste your time anymore, there are many ways that you can tackle this cost per bit question in a smart way. So you can offer increased speeds at less cost. And that should be the conclusion here. How we can do it? And the industry says innovate.
Thank you very much. We're closing by the word innovate, that Mr. Colcontroni said. I'd like to thank you, and at this point, we're going to close this session. We're going to take a break. Thank you, dear gentlemen, for your presence. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Thank you.